Good morning. Coming back to the floor today. So coming onto your lying position on your back. And we're going to move the pelvis a little bit. So working on this pelvic bowl. So your feet are on the floor. And just close your eyes for a second and sense the weight of your pelvis. Your knees are towards the ceiling. Let your weight drop. And then from here, you're going to send your tailbone up towards the ceiling. So imagine you have a tail, someone's gently pulling it. So my pelvis is not lifting off the mat, it's just tucking so that my lumbar spine can imprint. And release, and then you arch. So you send your tailbone down, so you increase the lumbar spine and center and tuck and center and arch and center. And then put your hands on your hips and see if you can lift your left hip towards your ear. So you're lifting it up towards your ear, towards your body, your head. And then return and then lift your right hip up towards your right ear. So it's a direction, yeah, you're not really touching your ear, of course. And return, and again, left hip towards your ear. It's like you're lengthening your right side, you're bringing your left hip towards your rib cage slightly, you're contracting it there, and center, right side. Maybe you notice a difference, sorry, a difference between the two sides. Yeah, that's normal to be asymmetrical in the pelvis. Okay, one last time, left, and then right. All right, and then you're gonna circle. So you're circling the pelvis. So whatever this means to you, don't worry about doing it perfectly. But what we are gonna try and notice is if we can make a real, true circle, so it doesn't, so it's not, oval. Yeah, so a lot of people are able to move one towards one side very easily and then the other side is a bit blocked. So if you can sense that and then really exaggerate the movement in that blocked area. And then reversing the circle. So all of this pelvic movement stuff is so important for the lower back, for the lumbar, you know, and on the cervical spine. So it's blockage in the pelvis, which is quite common because of the complication of that girdle. So there's so many things going on in the pelvis in terms of muscles, but also in terms of bones layering, and muscles layer on top of each other, and bones have, there are so many joints. So you've heard of the sacroiliac joint, I'm sure. Reverse your circles, by the way, if you haven't done so yet. Okay, and then from there, come back to your center and hug your knees into your chest. And you can use your hands, or you can use your elbows, whatever works. So if you could create a little bit of space in the lumbar spine, and maybe you just want to rock up and down, just gently, so you can lift and release the pelvis a bit. Drop the weight of the pelvis. Just sticking your head from left to right. You've got this pelvis skull relation. Okay. And then just lifting your legs up towards the ceiling, give them a little shake. Go. Okay, great. You're done for the day, so if you want, you can come to your spirals or do some abdominals. See you tomorrow.